Patrick, can you hear me? Patrick, wake up! Patrick!
Okay, we have established that this is Patrick.
You crazy bitch!
We've also established that you're not going anywhere.
What did you do to him?
Oh, I just gave him a little something to keep this all manageable.
What the hell are you doing here? What do you want?
I suppose I just want to feel something.
What the hell does that even mean?
It means I have plans for Patrick. Appropriate for the man that he is, he insists that he is.
You leave my husband alone.
Patrick Drake, loyal, conscientious lover. I know what I'm gonna do to him. But you, I'm not so sure.
This can't be happening. You can't be here.
Mm-hmm. Where am I supposed to be? Stuck in some sterile place between life and nothing? And that's where I was for months.
Whose fault was that? You stuck yourself with an infected needle that was meant for me. We prayed that you would never wake up.
So many prayers go unanswered.
But how?
I drifted from one nightmare into another.
Why come back? This is really what you want to do with your second chance at life?
Life, I wouldn't consider this living.
Well, then go. Go, Lisa, go live and leave us the hell alone.
He came to visit me in the hospital, you know?
Who?
Patrick, your loving husband. It was your birthday. He wanted to make sure that I knew my place, rotting in purgatory. I'd rather he just smothered me with a pillow.
So he would go to jail for killing you. That's what you would have liked, right? For him to be away from me? That was your big plan?
No, that wasn't the plan. I've actually flipped the script.
What's that supposed to mean?
Robin.
Hey. Glad you could join the party. Saved you a seat.
What the hell's happening? Untie me.
Now we're all together again? This is where it gets interesting.
How did you
get... So this is the problem with doctors. We always want to know how. I'm here. That's all that matters.
I just saw you lying in
there. And you're seeing me differently. I imagine it's how they looked at Lazarus when he rose from the grave. You know, some vile thing defying nature. Trust me, resurrection is no gift.
How did you wake up, Lisa?
She's about to go to jail for the rest of her life.
You raise your voice again and I will drag Emma into this.
What did you do?
Nothing yet. I'm sure that Emma's babysitter is very responsible, but I doubt she's willing to put her life on the line for 12 bucks an hour.
She's bluffing, Robin. There's no way she could have planned this whole thing.
Bluffing? Call it. What's the worst that could happen?
Oh, you're sick!
No. I am someone who was brought back against my will. It is something that I'm having to...
I don't know how you got here, Lisa, but I know why. Look at me. This is about me. Just let Robin go.
Spare me the emotional appeal. I have no emotions left to reach.
I don't believe that. You're hurt, and I'm the one that hurt you. I'm the one you're after.
After? That implies that I'm motivated by hunger or desire, feelings of unrequited love. I woke up oddly unencumbered by all of that. You know, maybe my soul thought I was dead. Not worth it. And left. Ooh. I can see by your faces that maybe you agree. I did it wrong last time. I was rushed, was thoughtless, angry.
You had every right to be angry. What I did to you was inexcusable.
Since when?
It's why I went to see you. I hate what happened to you. I hate what I did to you. I wanted you, I've always wanted you, and I wanted to go tell you that, even though I knew you couldn't hear me.
That's not true.
Yes, it is, Robin. As bad as it got with Lisa, I felt wanted. I felt alive.
You said you wanted our marriage back.
You dragged me to couples counseling, and I said what I needed to say. I said what you wanted to hear, that it wasn't about you. It wasn't about Lisa. It was about me and my issues that I had with my father.
So you've been lying this whole time?
I did whatever I had to do in order to keep my rights with Emma. I mean, what was I going to do, just walk in there and tell them that I was still thinking about Lisa, that I still wanted to be with her? I wanted you just as much as you wanted me. And when I got busted, I panicked. I covered my own ass and I said it was all in your head. But we both know that it wasn't. We both wanted each other and I still do.
Patrick, stop saying things that are not true.
Robin, we had a cozy life, but it was boring, let's be honest. With Lisa, it was fun. It was exciting. It was a rush. It was sex and we ate it up. We can still have that. We both want it. That's why you tied me up. It's not because you don't feel anything. It's because you can't stop feeling, and neither can I.
The old Lisa. She would have ignored this bold, offensive, transparent lie, and she would have done something impulsive, like take a moment of satisfaction and denial to believe it, and then hate herself, and then hate you, and hate your wife. You see, love and hate, it seeped out of me when I was in that coma, or maybe it just, I don't know, got lost in translation when I came out of it. Either way, one thing stayed very clear. You and I, Patrick, will never be together.
Lisa. Lisa! Lisa, don't!
What are you doing? Relax. I'm a professional.
Lisa, stop it! Look at me! Lisa!
Robin will always be under your skin, now and forever.
Lisa, don't! Lisa,
that
stop
makes
it!
This is all so fitting.
What is fitting? Stop! Lisa, don't! Lisa! Lisa, leave her alone!
You're getting a little loud over there, Daddy. Patrick, don't yell, okay? From this point on, we have to think about Emma, whatever happens.
Lisa, stop. Look at me. Stop. You don't have to do this. Don't hurt her.
But if she stifles you, why do you care what I do to her?
I swear to God, if you hurt her, I will kill
Patrick,
you.
Don't stop. Oh, so much for your big confession. Not that you're particularly believable. You know, I give you credit. And, you know, it must have been painful to act like you wanted me in front of the woman who you share everything with. Almost.
What did you inject in her?
Says I injected her.
I saw you jam a needle into her arm. What did you inject in her?
Oh, you're thinking overdose. Poison, drain cleaner.
Robert.
Ooh, you think that I want you to watch her die in front of you, but honey, what is the irony in that? The poetic justice. I told you, I thought about it this time, about how to give you exactly what you deserve.
Please, God, no, please.
Stop. You don't have to do this. Just stop.
How could I stop? I'm about to give you everything that you've ever wanted. You don't know, do you? But you do, don't you? Don't do it. Don't do it.
Oh, you know what? Maybe I might have misled you. I said I didn't know what I should do with you. Maybe it was more like how I was going to do it.
Lisa, don't do it. You don't... This is about me. You don't have to hurt Robin.
But Robin's in the way. She always has been. She needs to be eliminated.
You still won't, Patrick. If you infect him with HIV, you will be making sure that you can never be with him again.
But I've heard from Patrick's own lips over and over again that you're his one true undying love. He wants to share absolutely everything with you. I'm only giving him what he wants.
You think I'm scared, Lisa? I'm not. Robin lives with HIV every single day since she was a teenager. Uh-huh. And she's done it with more grace and courage than you could even imagine.
Is nobility really your strong suit?
You're gonna punish me with a virus? No, it's not gonna happen because I'm not scared. You know, you say you're void of love and hate, and I actually believe you, but what you're not void of is disappointment. You got nothing.
I've got the upper hand.
Nothing's gonna change.
Oh, my being here tonight will change lots of things. Ready, Patrick? Are you ready to really be one with your wife?
Thank you.
Come in